my creators, and today I'm here to share a Happy Mail video with you. This is an accordion folder I made for Avia, and I will first tell you a little bit of what I'm doing. I have the flowbook for paper lovers, and I'm using that, and now I have, I believe, 6 standard sized envelopes, and I'm gluing them shut to start the base of my accordion folder. And first, before I do anything else, I'm taking my distress ink in Gathered Twigs, and I'm going to distress up the edges. So I made this accordion folder for Avia as a part of my Happy Mail for her. I already uploaded another part. I made something mixed media for her. You can see that, I will link it down below. Now I'm taking about 1/8 of an inch of the envelope so it opens up again, and that way I have instantly a pocket, which is great. And of course Link is here to join me. So now I'm going to make some marks. I believe I make them at 1 inch from every side so I can assemble the accordion part of this little mail. And now I'm going to adhere tape between the marks, so not completely, otherwise it will not be an accordion. You will see later on what I mean. And now I'm going to glue all these envelopes on top of each other with some double-sided tape. If you want to see more accordion folders, I highly recommend you go to Vivian, the paper letter blog, her YouTube channel. I will link it down below. She also makes these beautiful accordion folders, and she makes them completely herself with book pages, so that is also something you can do. But I have tons of envelopes, so now you can see what I mean with the 1 inch space, so it can open up properly. Now I'm going to measure everything, and I want to have a paper lining inside on the side that has the envelope flap, so you can see it, and that will also be the side that you will see when you open the book up. You will see later on. So this mail is for Avia, and I made her an accordion folder a long time ago, but that one never arrived, so that was quite sad. So I made her a new one, and I really enjoyed this. It's a fun way to send out mail. Look at those kitty paws, it's so cute. And all the supplies that I used, or most of the supplies that I used, are from the flowbook for paper lovers. So now I'm going to adhere these pieces inside the envelopes, and I'm using some wet glue so that makes it possible for me to move the paper around. I don't think this is possible with double-sided tape, so you really need a wet glue. And I will do this to all the envelopes. And in this accordion folder, every envelope has some goodies in it, and the first one will have the letter in there. But now back to my story. So it got lost, and I was quite sad about it, and I also removed the video, because really I can't handle that I lost it and that she will never get it. So now I'm going to decorate outside, and I'm going to mark all the measurements on my paper with a pencil. So I'm going to take this slither out of the paper, and then I am going to score on the lines of my envelope. So this will be different for everyone. It depends on which envelopes you use and how big they are, but make sure that you can make a little gusset. I think it's called like that. So that you see, like I'm doing here, there's a small strip so the envelopes will fit in there. After I did this, I'm going to glue the envelopes on this paper, and then that is the base of my accordion folder. I really enjoyed making this. I should definitely do this again. It was really, really fun. And yeah, so I sent her something, and I sent her a tag I made a long time ago, and she commented on that she really, really loved it. So I'm quite sad that it got lost, but I made her a new mixed media piece, and I sent her some goodies. So yeah, it happens that mail gets lost, and it makes me sad. Now I'm going to make the flap of the accordion folder. I'm just using another piece of the paper that I already had. And I'm going to stick that on top of the little piece that I had left over. And that way, it's all going to look cohesive because those are the same colors that I already use. And I didn't have to worry about my paper being too short. I just fixed it. And it was an easy fix. And I really, really loved this. After this, I'm going to measure about 1 centimeter from the side. You can decide on which length you want. And I'm going to turn this little flap in an envelope shape because I thought it would look nice and more beautiful. So that's what I'm doing here. It's very easy to do it like this. And now I am going to continue finishing up my accordion folder. This is the piece I was talking about. It doesn't fit in the envelopes, but that's okay. I sent her this piece and the process video is linked in the I and down below. So now I'm going to package everything up and add some goodies in her accordion folder. And I think she could also use this folder later on for stickers or something that she wants to organize. So that's really a double fun thing that you can reuse this mail. That's also why I kept the decorations quite low, because it's up to her what she wants to do with this folder. And now I'm taking Brad, and this will be the closure of my accordion folder. And I'm going to take another piece of paper to hide the Brad on the inside. So now on to a little bit about myself. School has started this week, and you can hear that I'm quite chaotic. A lot of stuff is going on. I have big assignments. I have to do a lot of work, but it's great. We have a great assignment and I'm very happy to be back in school again. But I will also be very happy when it's summer break. I think everyone can relate. So it's good, but I'm quite chaotic and I'm trying to do all the things, you know, like we all try to do. I'm also starting to think I want to have a bullet journal again because I really, really miss it. So that's something that is on my mind. It's been on my mind for quite a while though. Now I'm going to cut the paper to size again so that it fits the flap that I already made. And now it's beautifully sealed away. And I'm going to add some twine for the closure, so she can keep it shut and I can keep it shut when this is going to be mailed out. I really love the pattern paper that I use. I really, really love it. It's so pretty. I wish I had more of that. So that's the accordion folder. I hope this made sense and I hope people understand. If you didn't, just leave me a comment down below and ask me. I'm happy to answer all of your comments. It might take me a little while to answer because I'm back to school again. You know the drill. And now I'm just adding some goodies in there. I have some Project Life cards, some stamps, stickers. I add some wood veneer, more stickers. I just chose some things I hoped Avia would like. And I think she loved it because she already got this mail. So I think she really enjoyed it. It was she had to wait for a long time. Simply because the other mail got lost. So I took a sip of my coffee. It's also quite early, so I'm not that awake yet. And now I'm taking some writing paper from the Flow Book for Paper Lovers that I thought would fit the theme. And I will stick this in the front and my letter will be on top of this beautiful, beautiful paper. And I think that's it for this accordion folder. So as you can see, you can add a lot of stuff in there and just close it up. I try to make it as flat as possible because I'm going to mail it. But if you don't mail it, it's not, well, it doesn't really matter. I added, of course, some dimensional pieces because, yeah, why not? I'm a rebel like that. And now I'm going to close it up. and this will be sent to Avia. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. I would love it if you would consider subscribing to my video and like the video, and please leave me a comment because I love to chat with all of you. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day. Bye!